I can feel the blood creeping up from the heathens. Got will, got fight, got pride, got reason. If they wanna go eat, then you know I'm gon' feed them. If you're coming for me, hope you're ready for a demon. I got eyes in the back of.
What's good, everybody? How y'all doing out there today? Hopefully everyone is doing great. I'm doing great. And today, as y'all can see, we are playing some Mafia 2 Definitive Edition. So let's get it, baby. Alright, so we are going to get it right into it. As y'all know, I played all these games. All of the Mafias, I mean. And I like them all, honestly. And I think this might be my favorite one.
My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925.
Okay, Vito.
That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away.
Probably for the best.
Away from Sicily, across the ocean.
He don't like
it. To start a new life in America.
America, land of the living. So they say.
Never in my life had I seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful.
Well, he like it now. Okay.
On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment.
Dang.
The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work. And what little money he made mostly went towards booze.
So he ain't give y'all none.
Eventually my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop! Vito, this way!
Where your bad ass can't run? Why'd he go
Stop.
First?
Let us shoot!
Shit.
Why did he go first?
Spread your legs
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry, Vito.
Well, that
yeah,
one time
you better
didn't
be.
Work out so
you
good.
Are sorry.
The year was 1943. America was at war.
1943, damn.
And the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18. And anything seemed better than jail.
Dang.
Who says he can't go home again?
18, bruh. That's deep. Chapter 1, The Old Country, Sicily, July 1943. Oh, he
Operation
went back home?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily. But we got hit by flak and had to bail out. Way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini's soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, I decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà. Eh?
No, no, eh? Per favore, no.
Oh, crap.
All right, Scaletta.
Allora,
take the shot.
Traditori!
What?
Oh,
Shit!
Gesù!
Ammazzarsi, era zappare freccio nere prima che arriva l'esercito!
Copro!
You and Williams take out that MG, then find the prisoners. We're gonna need every man we can get.
Hey, Skeletta, over here!
Daku, thank you!
Ain't getting through this way.
Looks like we found the machine gun. Watch it!
You got a grenade, Skeletta.
We had great fucking time to use it. Put a grenade through the window!
Skeletta, are you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Barely.
Get off your ass and let me move.
Whoa.
Grab all the ammo you can carry. This might be our last chance.
Let's go.
A grease bomb. Catch! Still fence.
Say mom! Don't kill me!
I see you. Bro, why don't you go out?
You missed, asshole!
Oh, right there. Got him.
Must have the prisoners upstairs.
Hey, bro, you couldn't kill him?
So how about you take point?
What? Come on, bro, go.
Buttami sotto tiro, a giro.
Got him. He in the army now. Is there somebody else? Oh, I see you. Dick? What you thought?
The door, Skeletta! Kick it in!
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare il cervello!
Boy, got him! What you thought? Ooh, shit! You died anyway! What just happened?
Shit. Looks like we're going this way. Come on then. Oh shit! How many of these fuckers are out there?
There's a fuck. Just keep shooting!
What the hell's the blue box doing?
Dude, more shooting straight off!
Hey, bye bye me, asshole! Pick up! Fight! Party!
Hey, shit! This balcony is in the woods!
We gotta keep moving!
Let's get inside!
Where's it at?
See that gun on the balcony, Skeletta? Get on it!
Bro, why me?
If these guys get inside, we're fucked!
Lancia a bomb!
I'm already down, bro!
Vito.
Saved by the grenade.
Che diavolo sta dicendo? Chi si crede di essere?
Un'offerta da fare.
Crepi davvero, Don Calò?
Cace e tu. Un congeco hanno samaritato come cuscino.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovresti ascoltare i consigli di noi altri del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete affidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day.
What?
Why? Because he told them to.
Wow. That's power. Home sweet home, chapter 2. 2 years later, Empire Bay, February 1945.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. And then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
We ain't going back. I'd rather go to prison than the freaking army.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading?
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of.
I should've kicked your ass, but he didn't even up.
No really? Shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
What are you talking about? Why are we talking about that?
Salud.
Ah, salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait, you mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here. Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is... Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, whoa, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right?
You owe me.
Risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you want a ride?
No, thanks. I want to walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow.
Boy, why you say that?
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
She all up in my grill.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Keep the change. Hey, what's the good word?
How you doing, soldier?
A lot better now that I'm home.
You want leave or home for good?
That's, classified. So, what's new around here?
Tell the truth, not much. Everybody just wants the war to be over. Mm-hmm. And they're saying this is the coldest winter on record. I wish I had some good news for you.
Yeah, you and me both.
Exactly.
All right, I'll see you.
Catch you later, buddy.
Yep.
Vito!
Hello,
you?
Mrs.
Vito? It is you. You look so handsome in that uniform.
Okay.
Your mother must be so proud. And what about poor Salvatore Montemaggiore? How's he doing? His poor mother was expecting him home a week ago.
He's probably dead, man.
Sal joined the Navy. I'm in the Army.
Oh, okay.
It's different.
Yeah.
Why don't you come inside and have some tea with me, Vito? You could tell me all about it.
Thanks, but I'm kind of in a hurry. I just got back, and I can't wait to see my mother and Frankie.
Such a pretty girl, that Francesca.
Yep.
It's a wonder she's not married yet. Well, say hello to your
mom.
I'm
talking about marriage. Don't be saying that. She don't need to get married. She good.
It's just one lousy beer. Crazy broad.
What a man.
Then he comes home at 3 in the morning smelling like gin and another dame's perfume.
Oh, you
hey,
a drunk?
Georgie, come on. You don't gotta listen to everything.
I guess marching
wasn't
your strong suit,
do
huh?
You?
George isn't going anywhere. Now scram!
That crazy broad really got Georgie by the balls, huh?
Hey, more beer for us, right? Let's go.
Drunk. You coughing, I'm gonna stay away from you. On this side. Straight, bruh. Whatever you got, you can keep it. What they looking at?
Open your eyes. Can't you see the stars and stripes?
Yeah, I see. You got good eyes.
Yeah, who said that? Who said that? You?
Hey, Mr. Manara. You closing the shop?
Yeah, you know how it is. Can't afford to stay in business though.
Wow, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, the war's not your fault, Vito. Who knows? Maybe when the war ends, I'll open up again.
Maybe.
Well, good luck then.
Hey, thanks, kid.
Yeah.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Mama. Mama.
Boy.
I miss you, Mama.
My boy's home.
Why you ain't come to see me?
I'll never see you again. Francesca and me, we
waited. We tried to see you, Mama.
What's going on? We waited for you.
Yeah.
Sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner.
Zuppa de pollo.
It's good for you.
Where's my steak?
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame Papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, la mangiare, la tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, provvedimi al tuo cucino di noi. Per Cristo nostro
Signore. Amen. Amen.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
Mama, don't tell me to go to sleep. I'm almost sure I played this on my channel before. Talk to Mama.
How are you, mio bambino? It must have been so terrible. I was so afraid. I prayed for you every day.
But you ain't come to see me, though.
I drove a Jeep most of the time. Sometimes I had a fight. So how you two been? Franny, what you been up to?
I still live here with Mama. I got a nice office job. It pays the bills, and I started paying off some of Papa's debts.
Francesca, we don't want to talk about that now.
Why you gotta pay off Papa's debts?
So, you got a boyfriend yet?
Not yet.
What's that? The boys in the neighborhood these days are not so good. She'll meet the right man one day.
Yeah, and I'm gonna beat him up. Okay, what is this? Is this my room? Really? Where the hell y'all sleep? Okay. Holla.
I see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
Facts.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
I know, right?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo.
Papalardo?
You could talk to him, work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Okay, Mama, chill.
Grazie a Dio.
I'm going in my room. It's private. Okay, Mama? What's sis at? Say? I'll be in a thot. Boy ain't even wash up or nothing. He just threw on his clothes. Wait a minute. Who was that? Mike Monte.
I don't give
I'm sorry.
A damn. I don't care
we'll
if you gotta
money.
Sell
hey.
Everything.
Hey, what the hell are you talking to like that?
Vito!
You might
mind your business, Esther.
She is my business. Yeah. Come on,
come
boy.
On, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Come on, take me to school. Oh, I'm ready to learn, woman,
huh? Come on, show me what you got.
Nice.
Peter, please. What? You're making it even worse.
Shut up. He's gonna die. Stop it, boy.
Stop, please.
Nah, I ain't stopping. Damn. Okay. You got one. Come on, boy.
Come on, coward.
Please, Vito, this isn't your problem.
It is my problem. You my problem. Boy, stop it.
You'll get yourself into more trouble, Vito.
I don't care. Stop it, boy. How you like that?
Ah, fuck this. Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, get the hell out of here.
Sorry. The both of you. What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark.
Of course he did.
Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
He moved us to his dump and now he got us paying for his dump.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Yeah, I bet he can. He owe you.